Another flea.
Jon Turmel studies all kinds of insects, fleas, bed bugs, and ticks.
This is an engorged female, and you can see how big it is. It's a misnomer that you can't see them. A lot of people think, oh, you can't see them, but you certainly can see this one.
Turmel says there are many different species of ticks, but the two most common in this area are the dog tick and the deer or black-legged tick.
That's the one that spreads Lyme disease. And yes, we do have Lyme disease in Vermont.
But as ticks become more abundant, reports of Lyme disease have increased over the past 5 years. Turmel says there are many reasons we're seeing more of them.
One is, of course, global warming. Mm-hmm. The other one is they're getting acclimated, and the fact that the deer population is much healthier, it's much larger, and it's also close to human populations.
You might think that during the fall, a walk through a field like this wouldn't be cause for concern, but ticks are resilient, and contrary to popular belief, they can survive through the first frost.
At this time of year, hunters that are sitting and waiting for deer or stalking deer, walking through high grassy areas, brushy areas, will easily pick up deer tick.
And deer are impacted by ticks as well. Reports from Maine are showing that both moose and deer are showing signs of anemia due to tick infestations.
We haven't seen the populations that high here, but it's something to be aware of and to watch for it.
It's clear hunters and hikers will need to be more diligent about checking for ticks after spending time in the out-of-doors. For Echo and News Channel 5, I'm conservation correspondent Bridget Butler.